Hello students, welcome to another class of computer lessons. So today we are going to learn about our fifth chapter. So what is that fifth chapter name? Working with the files and folders. So what is its name? Working with the files and folders. Right? Okay. So we have already completed our first four lessons. So let's start our new chapter. Then in this chapter, we are going to learn about operating system, Windows operating system, components of operating system and the features of operating system. So in this chapter, we are going to learn about what is an operating system. Second one, what is an example of operating system? Then what are the features of operating system? Then some important task or components present in operating system. Okay. So first topic is what? The operating system. The operating O-P-E-R-A-T-I-N-G operating system. What is the spelling of system? Yes. Y S T E M operating system. Have you heard about operating system? No? Okay. Operating system controls the functions of a computer. So what is an operating system? It controls the functions of a computer. So operating system control, C-O-N-T-R-O-L, controls the functions. Then spelling of function, F-U-N-C-T-I-O-N-S, functions of a computer. Functions of a computer. So first point, an operating system controls the functions of a computer and it also controls the working of a computer. It also controls the what? Working of a computer. What is the spelling of working? W-R-O-R-K-I-N-G, working of OR of computer. So, what is the operating system? An operating system, simply we can say OS. We can say what? OS. O, operating. S, system. Operating system. Then, what are the functions? It controls the functions of a computer. What is the first point? It controls the functions of a computer. It controls the functions of a computer. Second point, it also controls the working of a computer. It also controls the working of a computer. That is, the operating system arranges and manages your files on your disk and they can be stored, be opened very efficiently. Okay? Operating system handles input and output, handles input and output devices. Output devices. Operating system handles input and output devices. Then it manages the files. Manages, M-A-N-A-G-E-S, manages files. Then it also handles the external devices connected to it. Also handles external devices like USB printer or something like an external printer, external devices connected to the computer, connected to the computer. Okay, so what are the functions? First, it handles input devices, it controls the functions of a computer, it handles output devices, then it manages files, then it also handles the external devices connected to it. Okay, so these are the main functions of an operating system. So the definition here in your textbook, the operating system arranges and manages your files. It handles the arrangement of files on the disk. Disk means our secondary device, hard disk. Then they can be stored and opened efficiently. So the best example is, we know library. In library, there is a library, right? So we can say there is a library, and in library there is a guy, there is a man, library. And do you know what is the duty of a librarian? He helps the visitors to select their book according to their requirements. So librarian is, he helps, or he or she helps the visitors to visit the library, and he helps them to select the books according to their requirements. So he helps the visitors to select the books. Then next, he also arranges the book in correct order. Also arrange books in, books like in novels, short stories, essays, etc. There are so many different kinds of books in a library. So the librarian arranges books in correct order and in correct position. Correct order. Then he knows the total number of books available in the library. He knows total number of books available in the library. Number of books available. So that he helps the visitors to check whether the book is present or not. So this is a library. Just imagine there is a librarian. So he controls all the duties in that library. For example, he helps the visitors to select the book according to their requirements. Then he arranges the book in a correct order, right? And third, he knows, or she knows, the total number of books available in that library. Similarly, in our computer, there is a system or a device like, or software like library. Its name is what? Operating system. So operating system. So we can say OS, and the same OS helps to interact with the computer. That means the operating system acts as an interface between a human and a computer. So it acts as an interface. Acts as an interface. Here, you know, the librarian acts as an interface. Interface to select the correct books according to their requirements, right? Similarly, in our operating system, it acts as an interface to communicate with the computer. It acts as an interface to communicate with what? Computer. And in librarian, he arranges the books in correct order, right? So similarly, operating system handles the files and folders in the computer. So it handles files and folders. Then we know librarian, he knows the total number of books available in the library. So similarly, operating system controls all the computer working activities in computer. So it controls the working of computer. Okay, so once again, a library, there is a librarian, and the main duty of librarian is to select the, he or she helps the guide or visitors to select the books according to their requirements. Second one, they or the librarian arrange the books in a specific order and in correct position. Then third one, he knows the total number of books available in the library. Similarly, there is a software present in the computer like librarian. The software, that software controls all the activities in the computer, handles the files and folders, manages the resources, then handles the external devices, connectivity, etc. Correct. Then the examples of operating system is
and I interface.
graphical, G R A P H I C A L, graphical, user, U S E R, user, interface, I N T E R F A C E, graphical, user, interface. So Windows is graphical user interface.
Top. That is when we turn on the computer,
we can see a picture or a screen. That screen is known as what? Desktop. In the desktop, you can see three types of components. First, icons. Second one, taskbar. Then third one, start button. Start, S-T-A-R-T, start button, B-U-T-T-O-N, start button. So, when we turn on the computer, we can see a screen, and that screen is known as what? Desktop. In desktop, it contains three components. What are they? Icons, taskbar, and start button. Icons means what? We already discussed icon means. Example, folders, files, recycled bin, etc. Recycled bin, etc. Folders, F-O-L-D-E-R-S. Files, F-I-L-E-S. Recycled bin, R-E-C-Y-C-L-E. Recycled bin, B-I-N, bin. Then, you can take three components. First, icons, small pictures. Second, taskbar. Taskbar means, in the desktop screen, there is a long rectangular bar which is present at the bottom portion of the screen. There is a long rectangular bar. This is a bar. Long rectangular box. Long rectangular bar. It's known as what? Task bar. What is its name? Task. T-A-S-K. S-K. Bar. B-A-R. This is a bar. Bar means a long rectangular shape. It's known as bar. And task bar means this is a long rectangular bar which is present at the bottom portion of the desktop screen. It's known as what? Task bar. In the task bar, there is a button present at the left side. It is known as start button. What is its name? Start button. In the taskbar, at the left side, there is a button. Its name is start button. And at the right side, there is another button. It's known as show desktop icon. Show desktop. S-H-O-W, show. S-H-O-W, show desktop. D-E-S-K-T-O-P, show desktop. So, once again, the components of a Windows. First, when we turn on the computer, we can see a screen, and that screen is known as what? Desktop. Right. Then, in desktop, there are three components. First, icons. Second one, taskbar. And third one, what? Start button. Icons means, so here in your textbook, icons are small sized pictures that represent programs, graphics, documents or other elements. So what are icons? Icons are small sized pictures or images that represent programs, graphics, documents or other elements. Then, example, WordPad program file, folder, etc. Then second one is taskbar. The bar which is located at the bottom of the desktop. And it is known as what? Taskbar. Then start button. At the taskbar, there is a button present. So its name is start button. And at the right side, a button named show desktop icon. Okay. Then, Windows operating system was developed by a company named Microsoft. There are different versions of Windows like a Windows 98, Windows 2000, Windows XP, Windows Vista, Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows 10, etc. Then, why the name Windows? Why the name Windows? Because whenever you double click an icon, it opens within a window. It contains open in a window. That means that's why its name is windows. So why the name windows? Why the name windows means when you double click an icon, right? When you double click an icon, when you double click an icon, the contents will open in a window. Contents open in a window. That's why its name is windows. Okay, so you can open multiple window on the screen, and the window which you are working is known as active window. The window which you are working is known as active, A-C-T-I-V-E, active window, W-I-N-D-O. The window, currently working window is active window. Currently working window is for active window. That means you can open many windows on the screen, but the currently working on the window that you are working is known as active window. Then next topic is files and folders. Files, F I L E S, files. And folders, F O L D E R S, files and folders. File means it is a computer work stored on the disk with a name. File means what? File is a computer work. Computer work stored on the disk. So file is a computer work stored on the disk. With a name. So that is known as what? So that name is known as file name. File name. Once again, what is a file? File is a computer work stored on the disk with a name, that is file name. Then here, a file is your computer work. File in your computer is the computer work stored within a name on the disk. So here, the examples are, this is a word processor file, word file, MS Word file. Then this is an image file. It's a picture of a flower, so that is an image file. Then here, this is a video, so it is a video file. And then an audio file. So these are, we can call it as files. So examples of files, image file, video file. Image file is spelling. Example, image file, I-M-A-G-E, image, image file, audio, A-U-D-I-O, audio file, video, V-I-D-E-O, video file, word file, W-O-R-D, word file. Okay, then if you want to store your work permanently, you can store it via secondary devices or hard disk. Okay, so once again, what is a file? File is a computer work stored in a disk with a name. So that name is known as file name, right? Then examples: image, audio, video, word, etc. Next is folders. So folders means folders on a computer keeps the work file work together. Folders keeps the file and organized together. That is folders. Folders keeps the file and organized together. And organized, organized, organized together. Then this is a folder. 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 We can create another folder inside this folder is known as subfolder. Subfolder. Okay. So folder means what? A folder on a computer keeps the files organized on a disk. A folder in a Windows looks like, so here these are folders. A folder named Rishi, Rajan, Sunny, etc. So you can create a folder and it is used to keep the files and organize them. Then next is, why do we need folders? So why do we need folders? So if all students of a class place their books at one place, taking out their own book will not be an easy task. So all students of a class place their books in one place, so taking out their own book is not an easy task. So that if each one of them puts in his own bag, things will be organized. Same way, for example, there are some images of flowers. Imagine you have some images of flowers. Then you have some audio files or some music songs. You have some list of songs. List of songs. Songs. Then also we have some movies. If all these images, songs and movies are in a file, you don't need to select the files in a simple way. For example, if we create a file named flowers, you can copy all the images of flowers into this file. So flower, this is the file of flowers, right? And then create another file, and then you can store all the songs in this file, that means song file. This is the file named song. Then create another file and then store the list of movies. So this is another file named movies. And then keep all these files in a folder. So this is our folder. Just named favorites. And we can store the files of flowers, songs, movies. So it contains, what are the files? Flower files.
then song fire, then movie fire. So why do we need for dust? For organizing our files and keeping the files very neatly and in correct way, so that we can select the image very easily, or we can select the song very easily, or we can select the movie very easily. So why do we need folders? Folders keep the files and organized in a suitable way. Then, so today what are the things we have learned? At first we discussed about operating system. What is an operating system? An operating system controls all the functions of a computer, and also it controls the working of a computer. Then can you give some examples? Windows, Linux, Unix, Solaris, these are the examples of Windows operating system. Then what are the main functions of Windows operating system? We can handle files and folders. Then it manages input devices and output devices. Then it handles the external devices connected to it, etc. Then we have discussed this example with a library. So library control all the books in a library. Similarly, operating system control all the activities performed in the computer. Then next, there are two points in the features of Windows operating system. So here we have learned the example of the operating system, that is Windows. So Windows operating system means it provides a GUI. GUI means graphical user interface, that uses pictures or graphics to help the user navigate within the computer system. Second one, Windows provides or commands are in the form of pictures, and its name is called icons. Okay, then examples, files or folders, they are icons. Then components of Windows 7, when we turn on the computer, we have look a screen. So that screen is known as desktop. In desktop there are two components, there are three components. What are they? Icons, taskbar and start button. So icon means small sized images are known as icons. Then taskbar means there is a large rectangular button that is located at the bottom portion of the screen, that is known as taskbar. At the left there is a button named start button. At the right there is a button named show desktop icon. Then next, different versions of Windows operating system. Then why the name Windows? Because when you double click an icon, the content will open in a window. So that's why its name is Windows. And you can open multiple windows on a screen. And then the window which you are working is known as active window. Then we discussed files and folders. What is a file? File is the computer work stored on the computer with a file name. And second one, folder. Folder keeps all the files and organized together. So these are the things. So we will continue later. Thank you.